Our first guest up here is going to be Coach Andre Griffin from Lima Sr. Give him a hand. As he comes up, I want to recognize some more state champs. We got some Minster baseball guys here. So they won the state title. Go ahead, you can wave or whatever. There you go. Give them a hand. We also have the Special Olympics state champions over here in the corner, so we want to welcome them tonight. All right, thanks for being here, guys. We love having high school teams here, but we also wanted to have other sports because throughout the country, high school sports is just a very small part of all the sports that go on. Talk about right now, AAU time and rec time, and there's so much sports happening. And so we also want to recognize the Southside Spartans boxers. These guys are here tonight. How about that? A little dabbing. All right. And we also have Lima Select Soccer, a youth soccer league here in the area. They help put on a soccer camp, and they are in the corner, I believe. Give them a hand as well. So lots going on in sports throughout our area, and this guy's getting ready for his second football season. Lima Sr., head coach of the Spartans, Andre Griffin. Ohio State, 1998 to 2001. You were a Buckeye. What did that feel like? What were some of your great experiences there at OSU?
Well, as you guys might know, I kind of was born into Ohio State. But, going from there, I actually went to Lindenwood College first in St. Louis, Missouri, and transferred to Ohio State after that. The first year was great. If you guys are Buckeye fans, the 1998 team, to me, I could be biased, was probably the best team in the nation. We slipped up against Michigan State that year on the last second. You know, we had a muff punt, punt return, and things of that nature. But we went down to the Sugar Bowl and won against Texas A&M. So that probably was one of my best times. And, of course, graduating was even better.
You were the end of the Coach Cooper era and the beginning of Coach Tressel. What did Coach Tressel bring to the program?
Oh, Coach Tress and Coach Cooper was two different type of guys. Coach Cooper was more of a CEO type of coach, if you guys understand what I'm saying. He led coaches. Yeah. Tress was in the mix, and he was more of an educator. If you guys know his story, he was an educator. His dad was a coach, and his brother's a coach, and things of that nature. But he gave us books to read and things of that. And he's actually, I got close to him actually in the coaching profession more than I was in a player because that was at the end of my career. But Coach Tress is a great guy. I talk to him to this day.
Do you take more from him in your coaching than you do for Coach Cooper, or is it a little bit from all your different coaches you've had over your career?
I take a little bit more from Coach Tressel, more individual coaching. My running backs coach, before I became a head coach, I was a running back coach for years before I became the head coach. So I talked to a lot of running back coaches, and those are my mentors, one-on-one mentors.
How many guys do you still keep in contact with from your Ohio State days? You hear about the fraternity of Buckeyes. How close are you to those guys?
We're real close. Actually, yesterday I was in Canton, 30 all the way over at the Hall of Fame, and a guy named Devin Jordan did an event over there, and we had about 20 guys over there signing autographs for their community. So we keep in touch all the time, especially during the football season, and now with Facebook and social media, you can't get away from those guys.
Of course, you had mentioned earlier, if people don't know, Archie Griffin, your father, a two-time Heisman. What pressure came with you as a football player at Shaker Heights and then into college, having him as your dad?
I don't think it was too much pressure. My dad was a great dad first. Mm-hmm. I think, now they call them five stars. Back then, we were blue chips.
Yeah.
I wasn't a blue chip player. I was the MVP of my league, but I wasn't the top guy going all over to Florida and all that stuff. So I think, and also growing up in Cleveland, if I grew up in Columbus, I think it would have been a little bit harder. But for him, he was just a dad, and he came to the most games that he could come to, and he mentored me in that way. He actually was kind of mad that I gave up baseball when I was younger.
So, really?
Yeah, absolutely.
Was that your sport, baseball?
When I was younger, everybody said it was the best sport for me.
Okay.
But it was a little bit boring. I was a point guard, and I was a running back, and I was a middle linebacker. So, and then when I got to baseball, they put me in right field, so I didn't get the ball hit to me, and I was picking grass and doing all that type of stuff. So,
any baseball teams here? I don't know. We got a couple guys over here. Yeah. getting ready for your second season with the Spartans.
Yes.
What did you learn first year head coach of this high school, and what are you excited about for the fall?
Well, I learned it comes fast, you know, the first year. The organization came really fast for me, just being the head coach, the CEO. But this year, I think, you know, the kids are buying in into the program. The offseason is going really, really well. Having 14, 15 seniors that played for you last year helps a lot.
Yeah.
Great leadership so far, and we're doing the thing. So we're hoping to have, you know, me, I'm a one game at a time, one day at a time. Yeah. But hopefully this year we can make a run at it.
Finally, Pastor Michael Lyons was your chaplain last year. What did he do for you and for the team?
Pastor Mike, he's not here, is he?
I don't think so.
Pastor Mike.
You can say whatever you want.
But Pastor Mike's a great guy. He came to meet with me in April, right the first week when I came. And now it was his first year as a chapel. And now he's leading the guys as well, you know, having meetings with seniors and stuff like that. But for me personally, it's a great guy to talk to and have mentor me at the same time as I'm growing in my fatherhood and mentorhood.
Awesome. Well, thank you for all you're doing in Lima, and great to have you here tonight.
I appreciate it.
All right, thank Andre Griffin. You.